Barack Obama.
Yes.
Get the fuck out of here, Barack.
Yes. I remember Thug Nipsey. That was my guy.
Yes, I loved him. Yes.
How is it going today, Loyalists? Kingdom, my name is Dwayne.
My name is Jazz.
We're Dwayne and Jazz. Today we have the Boondocks Best References Part 2, real and cartoon compared. We did Part 1 a long time ago.
Yeah, we did. Long time ago.
So we need to finish up with Part 2.
Yeah.
So let's dive on in.
Later.
Yeah. I love the Boondocks. Whatever. The last Boondocks season was trash.
No, it sucked.
Trash.
Last season sucked so bad. That's why they only show, like, really the old season.
The old. I remember this episode.
This is from the new season.
Yeah. Wasn't it when they was like trying to create, like they was doing some
hair? Like some hair product.
Yeah, got them
like
a whole bunch of hair, yeah.
I love Riley.
Yeah. But I heard the original creator wasn't involved in the last season.
Oh, that's why
that
it sucked.
Black Jesus show or something like that.
Oh, Black Jesus sucked too. I didn't like that show either.
Yeah, I didn't like Black Jesus. I like
it. It was just corny to me.
Yeah. Yeah, remember the Breaking Bad. Well, Jasmine, I don't think you see Breaking Bad.
I get the concept of it. Yeah. I never watched it.
So
I'm
good.
Sorry, y'all.
It's so good.
I've never watched it, but
this is the RV van they used to, like.
Yeah, I get the story, though. Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Yep. And that was the guy. Didn't Boondocks start off from like a comic or something?
Yeah, it did come up. It was the Washington Post.
Because I remember seeing it. Mm-hmm. Yeah, like a style of it.
I used to watch it. I used to look at the comic strip.
Oh, I did too.
Yeah, the Boondocks was funny. I mean, when I seen the little comic strip.
I'm like, it's okay.
Mm-hmm. Not even the police.
They just let him go.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
yes,
my
I'm
God.
Talking.
Yep. Yeah, he goes the real scene right here.
Yeah.
Yep.
He was really in underwear?
Yes.
Is it because of the chemicals?
Yes. This actually happened in the Boondock. I mean, Breaking Bad. Real scene. It's showing you right now.
Did you watch the whole season?
I watched all of it. I think I skipped over a season though because I was just so many damn seasons.
Mm-hmm. And all that gas.
Mm-hmm. All that chemical. Cause they cooked
it. Were they dead back there?
I think it just knocked out from the chemicals. I can't remember. But I know it's because of the meth.
And he was standing out there.
Mm-hmm.
Just waiting.
Yep. Thinking that was the, yep.
Oh, mm-hmm. Oh wow, they copied it to a T.
Yes, they did, yeah.
And then you put it away?
Yep. And you just let them go by.
So I'm saying they're riding past him, but they're not going to ask him, are you okay?
No, he's good, you know.
You see a man standing out looking like that, and you're not going
to
ask him?
They don't worry about that. They got to go too. They got to go do their emergency. Right. There's some other thing going on out there. See this weird old guy just in his.
I don't know. That would be a concern for me.
Not if you know they do that. Yeah, he looking bad. He's just like, you know, whatever. You know.
Okay.
Oh, I remember that.
Was it that was a public television station or something?
No, it was Barack Obama's old pastor.
Oh. Why do you guys
just gotta
talk like that?
I don't know.
Looks just like him.
America, America, mother, America, daddy, America, can eat him.
Yeah, I remember him.
Typical 7-year-old. Oh my God.
That was the bad little boy. Mm-hmm. And they made him look just like it in the show too.
Yep.
I remember that story. I remember watching it.
I looked on the counter, my keys were gone. Mm-hmm. I took my gun because I got mad at my mom, and then I saw him have my friend come in, and he smoked a cigarette.
He started the vehicle and put it into gear, and off they went. 2 7-year-olds along the road. Letarian drove several miles through Lake Park in Palm Beach Gardens.
Fun to do because it's fun. Fun to do bad things. Mm. Drive into a car.
Well, did you know that you could perhaps kill somebody?
Yes, but I wanted to do hood rat stuff for my friends.
You know why you're here.
Right.
Yes.
Why are you here?
Because I'm a bad kid. I do bad things.
You said you do bad things. What kind of bad things do you do?
I don't listen to my grandmother, and I hurt people. And I smoke with cigarettes.
Right, he didn't even say cigarette.
Young boys aren't supposed to smoke with cigarettes. It can make your lungs sick.
I don't care about my lungs. It's fun to smoke. I like doing unhealthy things.
How do you feel about those people?
I don't care nothing about those people.
What if you killed them?
I don't care.
Why did you do bad things?
Because it's fun. It's fun to do bad things.
Oh my God.
Yes.
LaMilton Tayshaun is not a typical 8-year-old. While most kids in his neighborhood.
Now he got the little.
Yes.
He was leaving a path of destruction behind the wheel of an SUV he stole from his grandmother.
And I came into the kitchen and I saw my kids were gone. And I thought, oh,
really?
He went to pick up my friend. And he smokes with cigarettes.
Once he picked up his friend, another unidentified agent,
Riley.
The two went on a nearly fatal rampage through the Woodcrest area. LaMilton, what about the people you could have hurt?
I don't care nothing about those people. I want to do hood rat stuff for my friends.
See, you have to understand, all children his age love stealing cars and going on high-speed chases.
Now, LaMilton, why exactly did you steal your grandmother's car?
Because it's fun. It's fun to do bad things.
Salad toss, jelly, and peanut butter guy.
First of all, right, if he's a newcomer, right, I want him to suck my ass with jelly.
Warrior.
It means
that was part of the first one, wasn't it?
Or without jelly, some people use syrup. I prefer a guy to use jelly, right? I will reach my climate, right? I will automatically get hard, right? I will, you know, come.
Now, I like to put the jelly inside my ass.
Oh, wait, no, that's somebody else. That's somebody else in there.
That's
yeah.
The same episode.
Peanut butter, jelly, and sandwich. But down here, we'll be calling it lunch.
What?
Black guy running, Barack Obama, and then there's Hillary Clinton. And DMX says, his name is Barack? Interviewer says, Barack Obama, yeah. And DMX says, Barack? Yeah, Barack. DMX says, what the fuck is a Barack?
Oh my God.
Barack Obama? Where are you from, Africa?
Yes.
Interviewer says, yeah.
No.
His dad's from Kenya.
Oh my goodness.
Obama?
How do you not know that?
Yeah. He says, what the fuck? That ain't no fucking name, yo. That ain't that nigga's name. You can't be serious. Barack Obama,
yes.
Get the fuck out of here.
Are you supporting Barack Obama?
What?
For president.
President of what?
You don't know there's a black man
of the country
named Barack Obama.
His name is Barack. For real?
Barack Obama, yes.
Get the fuck out of here, Barack, yes.
I remember Thug, that was my guy.
Yes, I loved him. Yes.
No fucking way, man. No fucking way. I don't believe it. Stop.
I was like, I don't believe it.
I remember Thug. Oh, man.
I love Thugnificent.
Awakening since our last conversation. So, you know who Obama is now?
Oh, no, I knew who the nigga was. I was just joking.
You were not jumped on the Obama celebrity bandwagon because it will give you much needed exposure.
No, see, it ain't got nothing to do with that. You know what I'm saying? I started looking into his political positions and his policies and views and whatnot.
What policies?
Well, you know, I heard the nigga speak, right? And he was talking about changing some shit or hoping for some shit. And I thought, yeah, I mean, you know, all niggas asking for is hope. You can sit on your ass all day and hope. If you're too lazy to hope, you was a lazy motherfucker. That's all I
need. Donald Rumsfeld, known.
Unknown.
Known evidence of a direct link between Baghdad and some of these terrorist organizations.
There are known knowns. There are things we know. We also know there are known unknowns.
From the scene in the car.
There are some things we do not know. But there are also unknown unknowns. The ones we don't know, we don't know.
The absolute evidence is not the evidence of absence.
For Samuel Jackson. Yeah.
Simply because you don't have evidence that something does exist does not mean that you have evidence that something doesn't exist.
What?
What?
What country you from?
What?
What ain't no country I ever heard of. They speak English in what?
What?
English, motherfucker!
Do you speak it?
Yeah.
So you understand?
This is one of the funniest episodes to me.
Yeah.
Well, what I'm saying is that there are known knowns and that there are known unknowns. But there's also unknown
unknowns.
Things we don't know.
He said what?
Oh my god.
Yes, everybody knows about that show. I used to watch that.
Yep.
I think some of them like purposely destroyed their cars so that they could get on the show.
I love Pit My Ride. I think they're gonna reboot it. Of course.
Yeah.
They're gonna reboot it. I think so.
I think he's doing pretty good on Empire. So
yeah, but I still think they're gonna reboot it. They should. I love Pit My Ride. Pit My Ride was great.
I used to be like, how you riding around in that car?
Some people do, man.
I told you it's gonna have a new beginning. Well, it starts right here, guys. All right, take a look at your brand new Land Cruiser.
Oh, that's a pretty color.
Dang.
That is so pretty.
Please exhibit, pimp my ride for my grandfather for 9/11.
Riley was, oh my god.
Riley was just like crazy.
What's up, y'all? This X-Tennessee exhibit, and we here at the house of Riley Freeman, and we about to pimp his grandfather's car.
He was supposed to be blind, right? Remember?
Yeah. And couldn't hear that thing.
He saw it. He was like, what?
Oh, you see the real? I mean,
They're like, how can you see it? It's like, owl. I bet it looks nice.
Oh, snap. It's exhibit. Yeah, nigga, yeah.
What up, homie? I'm here to pimp your car. The only thing that worked was the off switch. That car was so old it ran on unleaded coal. But take a look at the new Dorothy.
Yo, my look at the rims.
Yeah, he's like, how can you see this?
Oh my god, Boondocks was so good. Listen to the comments, man.
Boondocks was so funny. Oh my gosh, the first season.
The first season.
The second season, I was trying to watch it because it's Boondocks, but it was just...
This is why the Boondocks is a classic show. Dang, yes. I remember Pimp My Ride. Those dudes always had a damn PlayStation in the back
seat. They did. They used to always put like all these like TVs and stuff in the back that you would never use.
Yep. Cigarettes. Cigarettes.
Right.
Why the F can't the writers get along on this show? With all that's happening, dude, Donald Trump won. The episodes for that alone would have been epic.
That would have. It would have been so funny having a parody of like the whole election and everything, especially what's going on today.
Oh man, like, they would have had so much material.
They would have had a field day.
I just want to do rat stuff with my friends. This show needs to come back. It does, man. I need
it
to hit
it. It does need to come back. I need to hit him up with the original writers.
His name is Aaron Magruder. You guys could send him this video of us saying, I guess, make the Boondocks come back. He was actually from university. He graduated from University of Maryland.
Oh.
His stuff was in the Washington Post.
Damn me.
Yeah, so, and we're in Maryland. So, I mean, this show was great. And
yeah. He
needs to come on, man.
Wow.
Yeah. But anyway, guys, please comment below.
Don't forget to like,
subscribe,
and share.
See some more, guys. Deuces.